Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, we'll be discussing what do you mean by production unit method. We'll be understanding how it is similar to the different kind of methods or how it is different from the different kind of method that we have learned earlier. Now, when we speak about production unit method, we basically talk about the similarity between the method that we did earlier, that is depreciation basis of machine hour rate method, and the kind of production unit that we have. So when we speak about depreciation under the previous method that we did, if you remember, machine hour method. So number of hours divided by the total useful hours of that specific machine. Similarly, now depreciation will be segregated on the basis of the production that a unit or that the machine can do. So when we speak about production methods or production unit, we understand that the total number of production that it can do in its complete useful life, that will be the denominator, and the numerator will be per year production that can be done by that specific machine, and that will be the numerator and denominator multiplier that we have. Now, other details that we require will be original cost minus scrap value. So rest everything remains the same. This is the only difference between the production unit method and the machine hour rate method. The production unit is replaced by the machine hour when it compares to machine hour rate method, and under machine hour rate method, or when we have to compare production unit method, machine hours are completely replaced by production units of that specific machine. This is the only difference that we have to understand when it is supposed to be done or when it is supposed to be calculated via production unit method. So I hope this definition gives you a lot of idea about what this kind of method is and what are the details that we need to understand whenever you are trying to solve this kind of question. So rest pattern remains the same. You have year-wise segregation, that means first 3 years, what is the segregation of production that can be done by this specific machine per year, basically 4 to 6 year, what is the production that can be done by this specific machine, and so on. And according to that, you have to segregate that thing and you have to calculate per year depreciation, and that's how we'll be able to solve the depreciation problem under this specific method. So I hope this gives you a lot of clarity about how this machine works or how this kind of segregation can be done using production unit method and what is the similarity between machine hour method and production unit method. So we'll get through more details when we start solving the illustration on this. So thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and keep subscribing to Ikeda.